Hello everyone, I welcome you all for the second session of the chapter Physical World. In our last session, we have learned about what is science, what is scientific method and steps involved in the scientific method, then physics, the main branches of physics, unification and reduction, and also the scientists who have achieved the unification in the field of physics. Now, in this class, let us write what are the concepts that we are going to see. Well, in this class, we are learning what are the fundamental forces exist in nature, then conservation laws, and also important discoveries in the field of physics. First, let me take the fundamental forces. Firstly, about fundamental forces. This concept is very important from your examination point of view, because most of the questions in this chapter is arrived from this topic only. So it is very important to learn about the fundamental forces. Fundamental forces bage tilkolo tumba important yakandre examination alli tumba sala ee topic melindane questions bandide. We know that a force is a push or a pull which changes the state of an object. So we have learned this in our previous classes. We can see so many forces in nature, like frictional force. I'm talking about the contact forces. Frictional force, tension, and even we see spring force. Likewise, we can see so many forces in nature. But the origin of these forces is only about the four fundamental forces. So let us see what are those forces. ನಮ್ಮ ನೇಚರ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇರುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ನಾನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಇರಬಹುದು, ಆ ಎಲ್ಲದಕ್ಕೂ ಆರಿಜಿನ್ ಏನಾಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಈ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಫಂಡಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ್ಯಾವುದು ಫೋರ್ಸಸ್ ನೋಡೋಣ. ಮೊದಲನೇದಾಗಿ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ಲಿ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ force. Third one is strong nuclear force. Fourth one is weak nuclear force. The four fundamental forces exist in nature are gravitational force, electromagnetic force, strong nuclear force, and weak nuclear force. These are the fundamental forces. Now we'll see one by one. What is a gravitational force? Gravitational force is a mutual attraction between the two bodies by virtue of masses. Let us write mutual attraction between the two bodies by virtue of masses. Yes, this is how you can define a gravitational force: mutual attraction between the two bodies by virtue of their masses. If we consider any two objects which are having masses, let us say that the first object is having a mass of m1 and the second object is having a mass of m2, which are separated by some distance. So any objects which are having a mass will be attracted by this gravitational force. Naturally iruvanta yavade eradu objects galige mass ide antandre aa eradu objects al madhya gravitational force idde irutte. Then what is the magnitude of this gravitational force? Let us write this. F is proportional to, the magnitude of gravitational force is proportional to the product of masses m1 into m2, and if the distance of separation is r, then the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance, m1 m2 by r square. If we remove this proportional sign and let us write a constant, this constant is g, the g is known as gravitational constant. G M1 M2 by R square. So this is the magnitude of the gravitational force. F is equal to G M1 M2 divided by R square, where this G is called as gravitational constant. So any two objects having masses will be having a mutual attraction. This force is called as a gravitational force. Yavade eradu objects galige mass iddare aa eradu objects madhya gravitational force idde irutte. Iga we are standing on the ground because of the gravitational force, because earth is attracting us. Namana earth attract martta ide, that is why we are standing on the ground. The planets are revolving around the sun because of the gravitational force. Sun is having a mass and planets are also having a masses, therefore they are continuously revolving around the sun. Next, let us see what are the characteristics of gravitational force. Gravitational force is always attractive. Always attractive. Gravitational force is always attractive force which cannot be repulsive. Yavaglu attractive force agirutte, repulsion irodilla eradu masses madhya, yavaglu attraction irutte. ಎರಡನೇದಾಗಿ ಲಾಂಗ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ಲಾಂಗ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಟು ಇನ್ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್. ತುಂಬ ದೂರ ಇದ್ದಾಗಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಎರಡು ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮಧ್ಯೆ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ದೂರ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಅದರದ್ದು ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನಿಟ್ಯೂಡ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ವೀಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು, ಆದರೆ ಗ್ರಾವಿಟೇಷನಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಫೈನೈಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ತನಕನೂ ಆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಲಾಂಗ್ ರೇಂಜ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. So gravitational force, what is gravitational force and what is the magnitude of the gravitational force and what are their characteristics, this we had seen. Now we'll move on to the next one. The second one is electromagnetic force. We know that in an atom there is a central core called nucleus. Around the nucleus the electrons are revolving in different orbits. So we know this theory. So this is a nucleus. Around the nucleus the electrons are revolving. Inside a nucleus we have two kinds of particles, neutrons and protons, in which proton is called as a charged particle which carries a positive charge and electrons carries a negative charge. So this electron and proton, those can be called as a charged particles. So when we take the two charged particles, let me say I have a positive charge and a negative charge. These are the two charged particles. So between the two charged particles there is a force called electric force. There is a force called electric force. When the two charges are at rest, then the force is known as electrostatic force. Static refers to rest. Whenever the charges are in motion, they produce a magnetic field. When these charges are in motion, they produce magnetic field. Suppose if you imagine a conductor and the charges are flowing in this conductor, they will produce a magnetic field around it. So the produced magnetic field can exert a force on the charges. ಒಂದು ಕಂಡಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ನ ಸುತ್ತ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದಂತ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ನ ಎಕ್ಸರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೈ ದ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. ದ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಅ ಫೋರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರೋ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೋರ್ಸ್. Now let us see what are the characteristics of electric force or electromagnetic force. Electromagnetic force can be either attractive or it may be a repulsive force depending on the nature of charges. It may be attractive or repulsive. If we have two opposite kinds of charges, there is an attraction between them. If we takes two same charges, minus and minus, two electrons, so there will be a repulsion between the two charges. So it may be a attractive force or it may be a repulsive force. Secondly, this force is also a long range force. So force can act up to a very far distances. So that is why this force is also a long range force. Dura hogta hogta force kadme aagta barutte, but still it can act up to a very far distance. That is why this force is also a long range force. Now the third one is strong nuclear force. Now the strong nuclear force, we know that in an atom we have a central core called nucleus. Inside the nucleus we have protons and neutrons. So if we take this is a nucleus, and inside which we have positively charged protons and neutral neutrons. The protons and neutrons are together called nucleons. They're together called nucleons. The force exists between the nucleons or constituent of nucleus is called as strong nuclear force. The force exists between the proton, neutron, or even if we have number of proton, 3 protons and 2 neutrons inside. So all these particles will be having a mutual attraction. Proton and neutron are attractive. Proton and proton is also attractive. Neutron and neutron. So there is a attractive force between the constituent particles of the nucleus. This force is called as strong nuclear force. Nucleus olagade iruvanta proton proton madhye irbodu athava proton neutron madhye irbodu athava neutron neutron madhye irbodu ondu strong attractive force irutte. That force is called as a strong nuclear force. So strong nuclear forces, the force exists between the nucleons. What are nucleons? Nucleons are the constituent particles of nucleus, or proton and neutrons. So they together called as nucleons. Now let us see what are the characteristics of strong nuclear force. I told you that the strong nuclear force exists inside the nucleus. It exists inside the nucleus. That is between proton and proton, neutron and neutron, and proton and neutron. So which can exist only inside the nucleus. If we take these particles outside the nucleus, then there is no strong nuclear force. So nuclear force can exist only inside the nucleus. That is why this force is called short range force. This force is a short range force. Short range means it can act only inside the nucleus, which is a very small one, so which cannot act outside the nucleus. Secondly, this force is always attractive force. There is no repulsion between proton and proton, or there is no repulsion between neutron and neutron even. So this force is always attractive. Always attractive. And thirdly, the force is charge independent. We know that the two charges repel each other when they are of same kind. Eradu charges so same agittu andre proton and proton they carries positive charge only. Iveldru madhya repulsion irbekagittu. But since there is a strong nuclear force, even between proton and proton there is a attraction. Okay, so this force is charge independent. It is not dependent on the charge. What is the kind of charge exists between proton and proton? It never varies. So it exists. This force is always attractive only. And even neutron and neutron, we know that neutron is a neutral particle. It does not carry any charge. But still, between neutron and neutron, there is a strong attractive force, which is nothing but a strong nuclear force. Therefore, this force, strong nuclear force, is charge independent. Charge independent. Fine. Next we see the fourth one. Weak nuclear force. Weak nuclear force is a force exists between the elementary particles. Elementary particles like न्यूट्रिनो और एंटी न्यूट्रिनो एट द टाइम ऑफ रेडियो एक्टिविटी. सो दिस फोर्स एग्जिस्ट इन सेवरल केसेस ओनली, इन स्पेशल केसेस. सो वीक न्यूक्लियर इंटरैक्शन और वीक न्यूक्लियर फोर्सेस एग्जिस्ट बिटवीन द एलिमेंटरी पार्टिकल्स. सो एग्जाम्पल फॉर दिस एलिमेंटरी पार्टिकल्स इज न्यूट्रिनो एंड एंटी न्यूट्रिनो, विच comes into existence only when there is a radioactivity phenomenon or like beta decay phenomenon. So in that cases only we can see these particles and this force. And this force is also a short range force. This force is also a short range force which can exist only inside the nucleus. So this is about the weak nuclear force. Now what are the fundamental forces we had seen? First force is a gravitational force, and this force exists between the two particles because of their masses. And the second one is a electromagnetic force. This force is exist between the charges. We represent charge by Q. So Q1 and Q2 are the two charges. So this force exists between the charged particles. And a strong nuclear force. A strong nuclear force is a kind of force which exists between the nucleons. Only inside the nucleus. And weak nuclear force. So as we studied, this weak nuclear force exists between the elementary particles at the time of radioactivity phenomenon. This is about the four fundamental forces. Now we will see which one is the strongest force and which one is the weakest force among these four forces. Let us write the order of strength of these forces. First one, we will write strong nuclear force. We will move in the descending order. Strong nuclear force, which is greater than electromagnetic force, which is greater than weak nuclear force, which is greater than gravitational force. If you write the descending order or decreasing order of the order of strength of fundamental forces, we can write a strong nuclear force, which is greater than electromagnetic force, which is greater than weak nuclear force, and which is greater than a gravitational force. So from this, what we can conclude is strong nuclear force is the strongest fundamental force. Strongest fundamental force is strong nuclear force. And at the last we have gravitational force, which is the weakest fundamental force. So the weakest fundamental forces gravitational force. Yes, so you should know these two concepts very clearly. Strongest fundamental force, you may have a question about this topic, which is the strongest fundamental force in nature. The strongest fundamental force is strong nuclear force, and the weakest fundamental force is gravitational force. Now we will see what are conservation laws. During any physical process, some of the quantities may change. For example, if we consider a heating of a substance, when the substance is heated, its temperature may vary, its volume may change. So, in physical processes, two or more quantities will keep on changing. But in all physical phenomena, in all physical processes, one quantity will remain constant throughout the process. So that quantity is called as a conserved physical quantities. So the laws which are governing these conserved quantities is called as conservation laws. For example, if we give an example of conservation of energy or law of conservation of energy. Law of conservation of energy. So if we consider the law of conservation of energy, in any physical process, the energy is going to conserve. For example, if we drop an object from certain height, what happens is this object is falling towards the ground. While falling, the kinetic energy of the object goes on increasing, but the potential energy decreases. But if we take the sum of kinetic and potential energies, sum of kinetic and potential energy, that remains constant throughout the motion. So the sum of kinetic and potential energy is called total energy. So total energy in this process is conserved. So conservation of energy or law of conservation of energy is one of the conservation laws. Next we have law of conservation of mass. Law of conservation of mass. In law of conservation of mass, if we consider any chemical reaction, in a balanced chemical reaction, the sum total mass of the reactants should be equal to the sum total mass of the products, which means throughout that chemical reaction, the mass should remain constant. So that is also one of the conservation law. And we have conservation of charge, law of conservation of charge. This is one more example for the conservation laws. Law of conservation of charge. So conservation laws are the laws which are governing the quantities which are conserved in a physical process. So law of conservation of energy, in any process the energy should be conserved. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. And here law of conservation of mass, in chemical reactions the mass should be conserved. So like this we can give an examples for conservation laws. Now we'll come to the last concept of this chapter, that is discoveries or important discoveries in the field of physics. I will write a table and you can just go through them. Here is the list of some of the important discoveries that took place in the field of physics. I will read one by one, scientist name and discoveries. W.K. Röntgen, who discovered X-rays. J.J. Thomson, who discovered electron. James Chadwick, neutron. Ernst Rutherford, nuclear model of an atom. Carl Anderson, who discovered positron. Henry Becquerel, who discovered radioactivity. Sir C.V. Raman, inelastic scattering of light. Archimedes, the principle of buoyancy. Here I have written some of the important discoveries that took place in the field of physics. Now we learn in Bardidivi, scientist name material discoveries in Anta. ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಇಂದ ಬರ್ದಿರೋಂಥದ್ದು. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಎನ್ ಸಿ ಆರ್ ಟಿ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ಕಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಬೇರೆ ರೆಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ಗಳನ್ನ ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ಇದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಡಿಸ್ಕವರೀಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ನೇಮ್ಗಳಾಗಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ನೋಡ್ಕೊಬೋದು. ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಬರ್ದಿರೋಂಥ ಈ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಈ ಒಂದು ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಡಿಸ್ಕವರೀಸ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವ್ಯೂ ಇಂದ ಮಾತ್ರ ಬರ್ದಿರೋದು. ಓಕೆ, so what are the concepts we have learnt in this class or in this session is what are the fundamental forces in nature. So there are four fundamental forces: gravitational force, electromagnetic force, strong nuclear force and weak nuclear force. So out of those four forces, strongest fundamental force is strong nuclear force and weakest fundamental force is gravitational force. Then we learnt about conservation laws and the examples of conservation laws, and then some of the important discoveries that took place in the field of physics. That's all for this session. Thank you.